Alright, so for this piece, I'm pretty much going to do the rest with pressure flaking. You can see this crack here. It's got me a little worried, it goes all the way through. So we'll just stick to pressure flaking and hopefully it'll stay together. I want to make a Thebes with it, kind of a longer diagonal side notch Thebes. We'll see how it goes. right where the crack is now. Okay, that went smoothly over it for now. I don't need a huge one here for the next flake because I'm gonna meet up with the crack. Dips down into it. I don't know if you can see that. So if I try to go too big, it'll dive right into it. Won't be good. So I'll take a smaller one first. That's a little too small. Nibbling away. Another crack showing up in the tip there. Should be okay. That's ugly. So ugly right there. I might have to stay on the final piece. really should get this piece thinned down some more so I can notch it properly. Maybe I'll just go for a good pressure flaking pattern at this point, try not to break it. I think that's split in two there. Those two. Sorry for all the traffic noise. Still haven't been able to get out to my site out in the woods. Fell down, but that was that big one that came down there. Oh, there's even more of it. You can see it followed the central ridge over there. That was a good flake. Rest of this is gonna be pretty tedious and take a long time, so I probably won't film at all. I'm gonna take a break now, maybe I'll just time lapse the rest, speed it up. Butchered that. I think Thebes are generally beveled. Anyways, maybe I'll do the alternate bevel on this. Give it some thick notches. Pretty classic looking Thebes, no fancy dog leg or anything like that. Well, I managed to get this far. Did all the pressure flaking. It held together, but you can see there's a kind of chalky, rough spot in the middle that kind of goes all the way through. That was tricky too. The crack right here somehow stayed together. I did it off camera because it was really slow, methodical work. Probably took me over an hour just to do the pressure flaking since the end of the last part of the video. I'll put some notches in here, probably off camera again. This is my pressure flaker. I've sharpened it a bunch of times, but for the notching, I'm gonna really have to do something. This is really thick. Yeah, really thick right now. I'm gonna make it a Thebes, which I'm pretty sure was a knife blade anyways. So it would have been hafted here, and then resharpened examples are often really short. So imagine I use this a bunch of times. It breaks right at this weak point here. I refashion it into a triangle tip, and then you've got your kind of more traditional looking Thebes. This one will be fairly early in its use life, but you know, mimicking a few retouching events at least anyways. All right, I'll put these notches in off camera and I'll see you soon. I think I got fairly close to a Thebes looking point on that. I did a slight, you know, very slight bifurcating base there. Fairly deep diagonal side notches. Couldn't dogleg it or e-notch it. This was really challenging. My antler pressure flaker couldn't really do the full job on this one. I stalled out, so I had to bring in the only metal tool that I use every now and then in emergencies. It's just a galvanized steel nail that I have filed all the way down over the years, tied to a stick. I feel like if I'm gonna cheat with a metal tool, this is a pretty good compromise. Anyway, there's the finish point. We'll call it a Thebes. Continuing our Ohio project. Gonna try and get that finished over the next couple weeks.